Hey guys, welcome back. Today I want to do just a little bit of an updated video about how I'm planning for work. I've had a few requests on if I'm still using a Hobonichi A6 for work, and I currently am not. I've actually managed to sneak all of my work tasks into my Hobonichi Weeks Mega, so I thought today I would just sit down and show you how I'm currently planning for work within this planner. I will say that I'm a very digital planner for work. I have a very digitally heavy job, so most of my like notes, to-dos, tasks, and appointments are all stored within like Outlook, OneNote, Jira, different tools, online tools that I use for work. And because I work remotely, I need to be able to very quickly send meeting notes out, export things, be able to share files within my team very quickly. So I do consider most of my work planning to be digital, and that was the same before, even when I was using an A6 last year. That being said, there's always things that I find work out a little bit better to have on paper if I don't want to lose tasks long term, especially when you get, you know, thousands of emails a week. It just helps to write things down so I know kind of what my deadlines are, my firm commitments, and they don't kind of get lost within that digital space. I think this will be the first video where you guys see my newest cover. This is a Vanderspeck Hobonichi Weeks Mega cover in the Janet Leather Brown. This was a custom order from VDS that I just received this week, actually. So I will leave the specs for what I ordered in the description box if you guys want to see kind of the specs for this particular cover. So within my Hobonichi Weeks Mega, I basically plan similarly for work that I do within my personal life, which is like everything high level ends up on a monthly view. Everything I need to get done for the week ends up on my weekly view. And then I kind of get into the nitty gritty details in the notes pages where I kind of do my daily logs. And my work planning really isn't that different. So typically within my monthly, I am using sticky notes. These are from Midori. I will list that information down below if you're looking for these tiny sticky notes, but I put in sort of like big project deadlines and like code migration deadline dates. All those really important dates end up directly in my monthly because I find I need to see that both at the same time. If I'm at the doctor's office and scheduling appointment, I want to know if there's like a huge deadline for work that week, or vice versa. If someone's asking me, can I give a target date for something? I need to say like, oh, I'm on vacation that week. That's not going to happen. That needs to come in a week sooner, or like push it a couple weeks or whatever. So I find having one monthly view to kind of marry everything really works for me. I do not keep track of work events and appointments from like my meeting schedule and stuff like that. All of that is in Outlook. I work from 8 to 5 typically, so I don't really worry about what my meetings are within that because I'm already like time blocking out that time for work already. So this is really just more of like, do I have like really big things due that week for work that's probably going to impact my personal life, or I need to like absolutely hit that deadline, that type of thing. So these are more like project deadlines or really big project events that I keep track up here. Within my weekly spreads, I basically will put what I consider to be important directly into my weekly. So that deadline that I had maybe marked in my monthly would make its way onto like the date specific portion of my weekly spreads. But otherwise, the high level, like things I need to accomplish that week, I actually just write in my weekly to-do list and I give it this dot signifier. So I just do a dot on the column to the left, and that is how I denote a work task. It just lets me see like Monday through Friday, I want to pay attention to those. Once we hit the weekend, I don't need to see them, or after hours, I can kind of ignore anything with a dot next to it. So that's kind of how I pay attention to that. When it's on this side, I don't necessarily give it that signifier because I'm pretty good about being able to tell what my work task is. But because this portion of the page is sort of like a running inbox for the week, it's a little bit longer and I like having this signifier to tell what that is. So that's kind of how I currently am handling that. This particular week, I had a work meeting that I was like leading a training, and I wanted to mark that out specifically, even though that was like a meeting that I don't typically track within my planner. But because it was like, I'm leading this, I'm the trainer for this, this is going to take up my time, I need to make sure that I'm prepared for that. That is an event that kind of like made it as a time specific event within my planner. And line in the sand varies from week to week, project to project. It just depends on if it's, I think it's like big enough where I need to put that in. So I've got it on my radar and I feel prepared for it and I have the visibility to it. So high level important work tasks, I just kind of mark in here with that dot. I've been doing that since I've started this planner. So there's usually maybe 4 to 5 things for work that make it on these types of spreads. And then flipping back to my dailies, I do essentially the same thing. So I've got 3 tasks here for work, tasks for work, and I just kind of write them in line. And these are the type of things that I find to be a little bit more important. My job can be very like inbox heavy. So I get a request for something and depending on the priority, I'll kind of have to take care of that right now. But I do have some long-term projects. So typically the things that make it into my dailies are like things I absolutely need to do for my long-term projects on a daily basis so that I'm not letting things get kind of swept under the rug with like the daily fires of requests that come in via tickets or emails. So that's kind of how I do that there. What I have found though is on like a not so busy season for work, that actually works perfectly. Just being able to see like my high level important to-dos and then adding those really important daily to-dos to my daily log, that's kind of been enough. But I've found recently that work is continuing to kind of pick up, particularly on a project front for me. And I just need a little bit more structure and the ability to future plan for day specific tasks. So my solution for that has been this guy back here. So this is by Hobonichi. It is one of their week size notebooks. They come in a 3-pack. I picked mine up from JetPens. You can get them from Hobonichi directly or typically off of Etsy as well. I think they have about 40 pages. So there's not like a ton back here, but I find it's enough for what I need. It has the same grid size as a Hobonichi Weeks, and it is that same kind of off color cream as the Hobonichi paper as well. And what I've done back here is I basically have created a vertical layout. I think it's like 7 or 8 squares per column, and I only give myself 6 columns because I work Monday through Friday, so I have 1 for every day and then sort of just like a running inbox for the week. Up at the top here, if I've got like a deadline, I put it at the top, and otherwise it's just small to-dos, things that I need to do. So sometimes I don't reach for this at all and I'm just looking at like my current daily and tackling the 3 things I need to get done and then otherwise just kind of doing what I need to do. But sometimes I need to take those 3 things and break them down further, or I have a million other little things that I feel like I just need to get written down so I don't forget them. I find when I write things down, I'm more likely to get them done. So this is kind of where I have been doing that. And I did go ahead and set up like 13 weeks of these verticals, and I do sort of pre-plan tasks in, and then at the end of the week, I'll kind of migrate things forward on what I need to do. And again, I've got those like high level deadlines and vacation days kind of already in here and ready to go so that this can kind of keep moving along. I can get about half a year in one of these probably. I'd probably use 2 or 3 within a year. I don't typically find I need to keep my work planners, because anything that I actually need to keep long term, I ensure that I digitize it so that I've got access to it within my computer, because I have such a like a digital type of job. I find that that works a little bit better for me, but pen to paper really just helps me stay consistent and on top of things, and I don't feel like things get lost in my email inbox and they're living somewhere and I know I'm not going to lose them. So hopefully this helped you guys. If you have any questions, let me know down below. I guess for some further background, I do work in an IT type of space and sort of like a support role, if that kind of helps you at all. But that's how I'm currently making my work within my Hobonichi weeks, and I like having everything in one place. But the slight separation of having that supplement book for like all the nitty-gritty details, and then on a weekend I can just pull this out and put it in a drawer, and then hey, I don't have to think about work. So it gives me a little bit more of that out of sight, out of mind, but I still have all the visibility to important dates and tasks within my monthly and weekly spreads. So if you have any questions, let me know down below. If you've made it this long, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.